Hey everyone, I'm Duke of the Bump, and sometimes I make videos. And today's video is a very special one, because this is my 400th upload to YouTube. I made 400 of these things. Technically it would have been above 400 a while ago, but there were a few videos that I had to delete because they were no longer consistent with my brand. You know, I had to do a little soul searching. But the 400 that are up should remain up pretty much permanently. Man, that's crazy. 400 videos. That's a lot. I've never done 400 anything in my life before. So I wanted to do like a marathon or something, like a marathon live stream or something to celebrate, but 400 isn't really a nice round number. You know, if it was 500, then I'd do something pretty special. But for 400, why don't I go on ahead and finish up Wario Land? This is the Syrup Castle. I believe this will be the last video. Let me switch my controller from analog back to digital so I can use my D-pad. So yeah, I mean, this sure seems like the last area of the game. I'm not 100% sure that it is, but it looked all dark and foreboding. And like a Mario 3 Dark World kind of level. Although I have to say, this music, not very intimidating. You know, I was expecting from the world map music, I was expecting something a little more scary, I guess? I don't know. But yeah, let's see what Syrup Castle has to offer. You guys can thank or blame CPC Gamer, who just started doing a Wario Land LP of his own, and it's pretty great so far. As I'm recording this, only the first video has been uploaded, but it's definitely something everyone should check out if they've enjoyed watching mine, because CPC Gamer actually knows some stuff about this game, which is, you know, the opposite strategy that I use, where I just go in talking out of my ass the whole time, which, you know, that's entertaining in its own way, but it is cool to watch someone, you know, super knowledgeable about this game go over the ins and outs of it. And I don't mean he's just like a super fan or anything. I mean he's actually like gone deep into the mechanics of the game and, you know, really took it apart and analyzed it and stuff. So yeah, you should definitely check that out once you're done watching this video. Wow, I forgot how loud that was. Or you can just pause this video and go watch his. You know, this will be here when you get back. Is there anything over here? Is there a reason to come up here? Crap. Well, that's not the way to do it. So yeah, CPC Gamer, by starting his Wario Land LP, kind of reminded me that I had my own Wario Land LP in the works. And I took an extended break there for about a month, and then I started streaming again on and off. And I wasn't really in the mood for streaming. There were a couple planned streams that I kind of blew off because I wasn't feeling it. But it turns out that I'm going to find out what's over there, and I'm going to sit here and keep babbling until I can pull this off. So yeah, I wasn't really feeling a live stream, but pre-recorded video, you know, that's a whole other category. Wow, this is depressing. Yeah, you know, sometimes I'm just not in the mood to be on, so to speak. Like, I enjoy doing live streams and I enjoy doing LPs for different reasons. With a live stream, I have the whole instant feedback angle, community interaction and all that. Oh, I guess this was just an alternate way to go. I guess I just wasted all that time. Oh well. So yeah, that's the cool thing about live streams, but the downside to live streams is that it is a little bit of pressure because I kind of have to come up with stuff to talk about the whole time, or I feel like I have to, and You know, you have to be in a certain frame of mind for that to be enjoyable. And right now, or lately, I haven't been in that frame of mind, but I am in the frame of mind to record some videos, because with videos, there's no pressure at all. If I screw something up, or if I feel like I'm being boring, I can just quit, and, you know, no one would ever know, and then I can come back to it later. And obviously, in a blind LP, that wouldn't be ideal, because you kind of want to have my initial reaction to everything, you know, my organic reaction. But if I have to, I will pause this and start over. Excellent. Now that's my kind of secret. What do I have to do to this thing again? Oh crap, do I have to be big to get the chest? It's been so long since I played this game. It's been like 2 months or something. I probably should have just done this video and not forgotten everything about this game. Do I have to throw a coin at it? I guess not. Alright, well, let's try coming back here when I'm big and strong. I don't think I've ever gone through one of those doors while I was small before. It's kind of weird. I didn't realize that you had to be big to open that chest. At least I'm assuming that's why I wasn't able to open it. Aw man, the exit's here. Well, I hate to give up that secret. I mean, not that I'm going for all the secrets or anything, but you know, the secret was right there. Alright. See how bad I am at this after not playing for 2 months. Alright, I remember you can move around. Okay, that looks good. Alright, so far so good. See if I can get this timing right 5 times in a row. Not too confident, but so close. Man, that one tiny little bar makes a huge difference. Nope. Try Wario. Yes, there we go. Oh, what was that? That was a direct hit. F off. One out of five, my butt. Well, I still got an extra life out of it. So, I guess I can't complain too much. Oh yeah, that's right. Like, I lost some treasures there a while back. I forgot about that. Well, since I'm not trying for a 100% run or anything, I won't worry too much about that treasure. I'd like to just get on with it since there was such a huge delay between the last video and this one. Now see, this is the scary music I was expecting. It's pretty good. What's with these blocks? Why can't I break these? Are these only breakable by fire or something? Suppose so. Oh, I see. I'd hit that pal block. Oh! It didn't get rid of them, it just moved them all up to the top of the screen. That's interesting. Oh, that's what those... Oh, man, this game is tricky. Well, the hat will still be there if I do the pal and come back out, so... I guess I should do that since I need every bit of help I can get. Aw, man. Am I gonna have to jump across those skulls once I hit that pal block? Kinda look like it. No, I guess I just have to go down that ladder. I guess those skulls are just for decoration. So it's those skulls to the right that I was worried about. That looked like a difficult platforming sequence, but I guess that's not a thing. Yeah, this is some pretty good music. I am shaking in my boots at this music. Now, if it's anything like the big final castle... Oh, my antivirus software wants to update. Good timing. If it's anything like the big final castle in Mario Land 2, then this will probably be the most entertaining video of the lot. Because that level caused me quite a bit of trouble. You know, it never pops up with that update window when I'm not recording a video. I think it might be a conspiracy. And I plan on writing a formal letter to the Clamwin antivirus company to chastise them for their anti-LPR agenda. LPRs don't cause viruses. People cause viruses. I guess LPRs are people, but different people cause viruses. I mean, I guess theoretically there could have been an LPR who made a virus, but it's definitely not me. I don't really know what that has to do with my antivirus software updating, but I think I made my point. Does not look like I will be able. Oh wait, okay. Didn't think I could break that block. Dang it. There we go. It's time to do some burninating. I guess this music is just a tad repetitive. That's kind of the MO for a lot of the music in the Mario Land series, it seems like. At least based on Mario Land 2 and this one. Crap. I tried to activate my dragon powers, but it didn't work. I don't think I should go after those coins, but I did anyway. Good going, Duke. That is some A+ video gaming. Aw man, I didn't even get a checkpoint or anything. Wish I could break these before I hit the pal switch, so I don't have to do this twice. Oh well. I guess it doesn't take that much time. Yeah, Wario's Castle in Super Mario Land 2 was not a very fun time. So far this doesn't seem as bad as that. But then again, I don't know if this is actually the final level or if I'm just making a baseless assumption. And you know, you shouldn't make baseless assumptions. You should have something to base it on. Pretty much the only thing I'm basing that on is the fact that it's a castle. And that the final area of Mario games is usually a castle. I mean, in Super Mario Brothers, the last area of every level was a castle. And then in Mario 2, pretty sure the last level was a castle. It was like Wart's Castle or whatever, right? And then Mario 3, definitely a castle. You know, that introduced the whole Bowser's Castle, that old trope. And I mean, there were other castles in Mario 3 and Mario Land, I guess. But, you know, Bowser's Castle was the big one. And this seems like a big castle. So yeah, I don't know. We're exploring this together, you and me. So I am planning on continuing my quest to play every Mario Land game, by the way. Mario Land / Wario. I don't know if I will start Wario Land 2 immediately. I don't think I can get that. Wait, no? I don't know if I'll start Wario Land 2 immediately after this one, but hopefully it will be pretty soon. I'd like to do Super House of Dead Ninjas after this. Finish out my donation requests. After Super House of Dead Ninjas, it is the DMC Devil May Cry game that came out pretty recently. And then after that, Sega did, I guess, Master System game? I don't think it ever actually came out in the US. Or no, not Master System, Mega Drive game called Undead Line, which is like a really tough top-down shoot 'em up. So yeah, look forward to that. But I think I should activate that checkpoint. But yeah, next thing is probably going to be Super House of Dead Ninjas, since I've been putting that off long enough. Yeah, it's a basket bird. I bet I can toss something into that, and it would be a pretty good time. However, that's proving more difficult than I thought. I think I missed my chance. Can I leave and come back with the enemy? No, I guess not. Can I toss? Oh, I guess I don't have 10 coins to toss in there. Nope. And I missed. Naturally. It is a lot easier to do this when you're tiny Wario. I have to admit, being little has its perks sometimes. Alright. I give up. It's not worth it. Wow. I haven't been a ton of invincibility stars in this game. I think that might be like the second or third one I found. I'm still kind of in the jumping on enemies mindset. And that's not the mindset you need for this game. Because most of this stuff I can pretty much just bump into. Now if I bumped into that guy's stomach, that probably wouldn't work out for me, because there's a spike on it. But in general, you can touch pretty much any enemy in this game, except if there's a spike on it. And then you just can't touch the spiky part. I sort of figured that's how it worked, but CPC Gamer's instructive Wario Land video confirm that. Very, very informative, that LP so far. However, I did learn that I sort of accidentally stumbled on a strategy for fighting the first boss in the game that CPC Gamer wasn't aware of, where you can jump up and hit him from below. I couldn't tell if it went in the bird or not. Then I accidentally killed the bird. I'm kind of a monster. So yeah, that was fun. I felt helpful discovering a hitherto unknown boss strategy. I mean, I'm sure I didn't discover it. Other people discovered it, but CPC Gamer wasn't aware of it. I mean, not that I was lead or anything, I just kind of, if I hit my head on the thing, it should do the thing, you know, just. I don't like that ladder. I guess that looks like a final castle, with the skull and everything. So yeah, I do have a reason to assume that that's the final level. Also, the fact that it's starting to get a little tricky. At least it is on those ladders. Man, this is a lot harder than you would think. I'm gonna try one more time. Now that I'm tiny. I mean, all you get from this is a bunch of coins, I think. So it's not even really that important. There we go. 30 coins. So yeah, that's not... I mean, that's not going to be a game changer or anything, but... I felt good pulling it off. That's the important thing. Video games should feel good to play. You know, if you're just, collecting things for the sake of collecting them, that's not as satisfying as when the game itself is actually good. Like, case in point, I spent a ton of time playing Shovel Knight recently, which you can see videos of me live streaming it on my channel. And Shovel Knight is an excellent game. It plays super well, the mechanics are super solid, and there's also a bunch of stuff for you to do in the game. There are collectibles. Alright, this is where it keeps screwing me up. I have to figure out why I keep falling here. I was holding up the whole time. But Shovel Knight, super solid game, all around. Everything about it is great. And I spent like 40 hours playing the game so far to get more of the achievements. And I don't even care about achievements normally. It was just an excuse for me to play more of the game. And contrast that with Tomb Raider, which I also played recently. The 2013 big budget Tomb Raider, I guess it's a reboot or maybe a prequel, I'm not sure. But I played that recently as well, and it was okay. It looked gorgeous, you know, the sound design was excellent. From a production standpoint, everything about it was great, but mechanically, the game was just really not enticing. I mean, there was shooting, which was kind of okay, but not really, since I was playing with a controller, and having to aim without a mouse in a game like that is always unsatisfying. And I could have played that game with the mouse and keyboard, but then the platform parts would have felt really weird doing that with the mouse and keyboard, so I opted to use a controller. And you know, there were just quick time events everywhere, and there we go. I don't know why I had so much trouble with that before, but I mean, it was an okay game, you know. I'm glad I played it. I'm glad I only paid $5 for it on Steam. But it did not have the stickiness for me that Shovel Knight did. Even though there are billions of things to collect in that game, and you could probably spend a good, I think I beat the game in 12 hours. You could probably spend equally that just going back and finding all the collectibles. But that game, it doesn't really give me a reason to want to do that. You know, playing the game, the act of playing the game doesn't feel good. And my point is, I'm probably not going to go for like a 100% run or try to get all the treasures or anything in this game, because it's not that sticky for me. I mean, it's a fun game, don't get me wrong. I'm having a great time with it. But the actual fundamental mechanics of the game aren't good enough to make me want to go for 100%. Now, obviously, I'm playing this with the benefit of years of advances in video game design and technology and all that. And, you know, I can't really pass judgment on this game because it was a product of its time. I'm sure if I had a Game Boy and I had this game when it came out, I probably would have played this game to death like I did with the original Super Mario Land, even though the original Super Mario Land isn't that great either. It's fun. You know, it's a fine game, and this is a fine game, but in the pantheon of Mario games, oh Christ, it doesn't rank that highly for me, unfortunately. And this is a pretty good example of why. This is actually kind of reminding me of the castle in Super Mario Land 2, where I had a fundamental action in the game, which I think was just jumping on a platform or jumping off a platform or something like that. Just something totally fundamental about the game. It's not like I'm not trying for some amazing secret or anything. I'm not, you know, this is not bonus content. Those ladders do not lead to a super secret area with 100 extra lives. This is just something I have to do in the game. And for whatever reason, it's not clicking with me. I'll tell you one thing, I am super glad I got that checkpoint now. Because if I had to do this whole thing over again, well, eventually I would have figured out that I needed to hit that checkpoint. But man, without that checkpoint, this would be even more frustrating than it is. I mean, I don't think there's anything I'm missing about those ladders. I mean, I don't think sticking in the ceiling would really do me much good, because it's not like I can move. Or actually, I don't think I can't even stick on the ceiling with these ladders. You can't jump off the ladders. I'm hitting the jump button and that does nothing. I guess I have to like get as far over on the ladder as possible before I... I don't know. Do not know what I am doing wrong. It's okay. Just a video game. I'm not going to get mad at video games. Because that's not how I roll. Used to be how I roll, but I sort of gotten over that aspect of my video game playing career. Like, the first few times I played through Shovel Knight, the first couple times, it was pretty difficult, especially, like, the boss rush and stuff towards the end of the game. And, I think the first time I played Shovel Knight, I died, like, 100 times throughout the course of the game. Most of those in the last few levels. And it got a little bit frustrating, but I persevered. But the thing is, in Shovel Knight, the difficulty seemed fair. Like, this does not seem fair. This seems like something bad about the controls. I should be able to just jump from this ladder to the next ladder. I don't know why I have to do it like that. I can't do like my bull charge or anything either. And there's like three of these that I have to get through so far. What the? Oh, I guess I stuck in the ceiling. Okay. I thought it paused. I was like, what the heck? Alright. I think I got this. Alright. I was trying to do like a hold up and to the right, like a diagonal kind of thing, and I think it required a discrete button press to latch on back to the ladder. Can I just charge through these? Or do I have to... Crap. I don't think I can. Oh, I guess I can. Okay, cool. Alright, well... that could have been better, but, I could have figured that out more quickly, too. Wow. Got Michael Bay up in here for a second. Alright, let's try the heart game again, I guess. Since I have 20 coins. Enough for the C course. Crap. See, the thing about the difficulty level is that it doesn't change the speed of the power meter. That's the same every time. So if you can't get the basics of that down, I think that should have counted as a hit. Once again, I'm sure if I was a kid and I had this on the Game Boy, I would just practice that over and over and over again until I could do it, you know, get 5 every single time like CPC Gamer used to be able to. But I'm doing this as a grown-ass man, and I'm not the video game player I once was. But that'll about do it for the first half of Syrup Castle. Sorry for the ladder difficulties. Hopefully we won't have difficulties like that in Syrup Castle Part 2. Undo the bump. Goodbye.